kept. So I'm gonna make this quick. This looks like my camera battery is dying. But I wanted to talk about Mr. Kevin Samuels. Now, I know he's a controversial figure because, you know, he has an opinion of his own that doesn't seem to correlate with what's popular in society. But I want to talk about him in a different light, more of a, you know, I want to talk about him first as, you know, businessman. You know, the guy took his business seriously. You know, I believe he was an image consultant first before he became, you know, a popular YouTube star that most people know. I actually came across Kevin Samuels probably around COVID or a little bit before COVID for his style advice, you know, and it wasn't necessarily that I was trying to use his style advice. Those high heel boots and stuff wouldn't really fit my body type all that well, but I did get a lot of use out of his cologne and cologne advice. That kind of stuff was really cool. You could dip, mix and match different colognes to get, you know, the optimal use out of them and places to put them. I didn't know any of that stuff. I'm not afraid and ashamed to admit it. I didn't know. And a lot of stuff served me well. My wife loves a lot of the clones that I bought based on his suggestion. So I want to thank him for that. And I also want to thank him for really, you know, showing that YouTube is in fact a business. A lot of people, black folks in particular, seem to think that YouTube is a place you just go to talk shit all day. Which, you know, it's fine if you make money doing that. Good for you. But he actually treated it as though it were, you know, a corporate business. Streams, he wouldn't allow people to cut him off, interrupt, you know, curse him out, or just be obnoxious in general, because you wouldn't allow someone to act that way in your business. If you owned, you know, a gym or, you know, a club or bar, you wouldn't allow someone to come into your bar, start knocking stuff over, throwing chairs around, you know, disrespecting the weight room, disrespecting customers and all that kind of stuff. You wouldn't allow that, would you? No, you would remove them as soon as physically possible. So that's what he would do. You know, he treated it as a real business, and he got the results that he was looking for. Regardless of what people feel about his, you know, controversial topics, you know. And you know what? Let me speak on that for a minute. And I don't understand what's so controversial about a man giving his opinion, right? Maybe you don't like it. Maybe you don't. If you don't like it, turn it off. I make fitness content. If you don't care about fitness, don't watch it. Keep it moving. I hope you do. Maybe you can take something from it. But if you don't want to watch it, it's fine. I understand. You might be completely against exercise. But don't come to my channel telling me that I'm wasting my time when I actually enjoy what I'm doing. And that's what he did. He enjoyed his content. From what I could tell, he actually felt that this would make a difference, that he might be able to, in fact, help the black community, help the dating community, seeing the relationships. Now, again, I came across him, I already had, you know, a wife and children. So none of that stuff really, like, applied to me. I just checked it out because I wanted to know why what he was saying was so controversial. To me, he was just talking to people, you know, women in particular, as human beings. Now, I remember him in the earlier days, you know, like 2 years ago, where he didn't really address women that much. It was mostly men, and he tore into those guys, and a lot of them deserved it. You know, basically he was saying, get your money up, you know, get in shape, be healthy, and be better. You know, you can't have these unrealistic expectations running around, wishing and hoping and praying that, you know, this 10 out of 10 is going to fall in your lap just for you simply existing. That's not a healthy mindset, and that's just not how reality works. And, you know, there was no problem there when he was doing it to men, but crosses over, starts doing it to women, and all of a sudden it's a problem. But you take that what you will. I also admire Mr. Samuels for, you know, being brash, being honest, and really just giving his honest opinion. Ah, fuck. So my camera cut out real quick. But the guy spoke his mind, you know, he gave his opinion and he kept it. You know, he didn't get caught up in a lot of drama. That a lot of people get caught up with on YouTube. So you gotta admire him for that. He was about making his money, and that's what he did. He became an icon. You know, a guy that was known for being, I guess you could call him a regular person, you know, average, everyday citizen, to becoming, a celebrity. And it is a shame that on his ascension is when he passed away. And, you know, condolences to him and his family. And I get how, you know, people can be upset at some of the stuff he said. I get it. You know, the truth hurts a lot of times. But it shouldn't be anything to where you're wishing, you know, ill will or death upon somebody just because they have an opinion that you disagree with. It seems silly to me and very short-sighted, because at the end of the day, you probably end up agreeing with him as the course of your life continues. And what he said turned out to be true. But that's the issue right there. But again, I respected him.
Maybe it was
inspire some other people to follow in his footsteps. You know, maybe not on the topics that he spoke about, but to really invest themselves in the potential of YouTube, in the potential of, you know, just media in general, and talking about what he talked about. Yes, you can talk about it. You can say these things. Will you have some backlash? Sure. But if you're not, you know, if you're not having people ask questions, are you really, you know, you're really talking about something that matters? You know, and a lot of times, you know, even with the fake stuff that I do, I feel like a lot of stuff that I talk about matter, and that, you know, somebody should say it. Hopefully it helps you. And that's what he was doing. You know, he's putting it out there. Hopefully it helped you. You know, and from what I understand, it did help people. You know, he had people, you know, women stay in their marriages. Which